And we're back after a lusty rendition of National Anthem by the Trinidad and Tobago team.
Yes, those guys were singing very heartily, I must say.
We'll take this opportunity here to go over the team listing here. First for Bermuda, we've got starting 15 being BJ Bragman. Number 1, number 19, Colin McGlynn. Number 3, Dustin Archibald. Number 5, Captain Peter Dunkley. Number 8, Aldo Campbell. Number 6, Tayshaun DeSilva. Number 10, Thomas Greenslade. Number 18, Brynlyn Toms. Number 9, Thomas Healy. Number 7, Brian Archibald. Number 21, Nigel Burgess. Number 15, Connor McGowan. Number 13, Alex Brown. Number 14, Janico Francis. And number 11, Antonio Leader.
Pretty chef. I'm the Trinidad and Tobago team. We have starting. We have Trizine McLean at 1. Number 2, Felician Guerra. Number 3, Ernest Wright. Number 21 will be Jamal Clark. Number 4, Kirby Hosang. Number 6, Wayne Kelly. Number 7, Gordon Daglish. Number 8, Jesse Richards. Number 9, Christopher Hudson. Number 10, Sebastian Navarro. Number 11, Anderson Joseph. Number 12, Dexter Snags. Number 13, Joseph Quashi. Number 14, James Phillip. And rounding it off, at number 15, we have Leon Pantor. And the game is about to start. We are waiting for the kickoff.
And as we watch the picture of the field here, Bermuda in the blue and purple strips, Trinidad and Tobago in the traditional red and black strips. The southern side of the pitch will be to the left-hand side of your screen, Bermuda to the northern side, which is to the right. And in the backdrop, Tabati will see a nice lush green hills and beautiful houses in the backdrop of Westmoreland.
Yes, I'm even watching the field right now. I find the field is looking really, you know, green.
Healthy.
Yes, because this time it would be normally, the grounds are normally still about a little bit hard. Yeah, tough.
A bit tougher than usual, usually for the time of year. But Tabati, what kind of game plan do you expect Bermudans to display it here today against Trinidad and Tobago?
Well, I'm watching the size of their guys. They look rather, for the majority of it, they look rather big. So I'm thinking they will probably come at a pack pounding game, trying to hit us directly. What do you think?
Well, I don't believe Bermuda is trying to play a quick game with us, but I know that they're going to try to keep it in the big guys. I will see the match about to start by debutant Sebastian Navarro at number 10, ready to start the game off us.
And there we have it. The whistle is blown.
And as we see, aggressive tactics by Trinidad and Tobago from early, but the sheer weight of the Bermudan team just keeps at us bay. Thumping tackle here by the Trinidad and Tobago forwards here. Everyone trying to test each other out here. As Bermuda trying to leave their half of the pitch.
The ball is still in their possession.
Oh, kick charge done by Trinidad and Tobago there. Trinidad and Tobago on the advantage as Kirby Hosang coming into contact here. Trinidad and Tobago on the way forward here. Again, let's see what young Sebastian Navarro does here at 10. Oh, Trinidad and Tobago smothered here by the big Bermudan team here. No advantage was gained here as the referee brings it back for the knock-on by the Bermudan team here. Yes, there'll be a scrum down here to Trinidad and Tobago.
The ball was taken in by number 13, Joseph Quashi of Trinidad and Tobago. And as Kelton said, there'll be a scrum down.
And as we start the game, very frantic pace at the start here. Both teams trying to feed each other out here.
Showing their aggression, I must say.
Bermuda with a bigger pack we're going to see in the scrum time, which will be at their advantage. But Trinidad and Tobago, the fairly quicker runners in the back line. We're going to see how well they are going to attack this Bermudan team here.
Well, I'm interested in seeing the scrum, because Trinidad and Tobago are putting a lot of work on the scrum coming up, leading up to this match.
And as we can see, the Bermudans trying to bully Trinidad and Tobago into submission here. And Trinidad and Tobago giving away the penalty there. And again, that's exactly a tactic that Bermuda's come here to do. Use their sheer weight. They're going to kick the ball down in a penalty situation and get the possession back lower down the pitch and really going to rumble it back at us. Not a great kick by the Bermudans.
I was just about to say that.
Not much advantage, but we're going to see the set pieces here, which Trinidad and Tobago are known for being excellent at.
Yes, they have an excellent jumper who they lift. His name is Shaquille Dight. He's very good in the air, very good at catching the ball in the air. Let's see how this goes, if he can steal this one from Bermuda. Oh.
Uncontested line out here by Trinidad and Tobago. And we're going to have opportunity again to see the sheer strength of the Bermudan boys here. They're going to rumble this mall all the way forward. Trinidad and Tobago has no answer for it at the moment.
Okay, looks like the mall is almost collapsed.
And Bermuda has made great yardage forward, at least 10, 15 meters, and still going. Trinidad and Tobago can't seem to stop it, and the play has stopped now. We're going to see the Bermudan backline and their set pieces.
Yes,
and again, tackle here. Great aggression by the Bermudan players here. And Trinidad and Tobago see on the defensive at the moment.
Ooh. Trinidad and Tobago almost steal the ball here from Bermuda line, trying to gain some yards.
Yeah, unlucky by the intercept by the big Jamal Clark there. And again, for Bermuda team, we need to look at the nifty number 9, Tom Healy, 7 specialist as well. He's one of the guys that represents this team in both the 15-a-side version and the 15-a-side version. So you can look forward to him to be a thorn in the Trinidad and Tobago side here today.
But we have a lot of this on the Trinidad and Tobago side as well. I mean, as in players playing both versions of the game. I think they have a tournament coming up later this year.
I believe Trinidad and Tobago plays CAC games in Colombia in July of this year.
Okay, and that team is has commenced training already. So we expect some good results there as well.
And as we look at the bully number 20 for Bermuda playing at number 10, Phil Hall. Seemed to be way bigger stature than the Trinidad and Tobago 10. Sebastian Navarro, if he decides to challenge him one-on-one, it's going to be a tough ask for him. And again, we have a scrum down with a knock-on from Trinidad and Tobago. As we see Bermuda again trying to assert their dominance with a mighty, much heavier pack than the Trinidad and Tobago team.
And I must say they are very close to the, they are very much into the Trinidadians territory.
And can Trinidad and Tobago stop this drive as the ball is out and stolen by Gordon Daglish of Trinidad and Tobago, but again given away, and it's Bermuda back on the attack. As we see again another scrum here, and this scrummaging is going to take a toll on these big guys on this Bermudan team here, with the amount of contact being taken.
But the game is fairly young, but I'm seeing some good heavy crunching tackles already in this game. I believe we went to see if this is going to be a very physically contested game, I must say.
5 minutes into this, and it's third scrum in this session so far. As again, Trinidad and Tobago can't seem to stop the big, burly Bermuda team. Trinidad and Tobago play a bit of territory. Well guarded in the end by the Bermudan fullback, and again, he sent it up the pitch.
I won't say much for that kick again, Kelson. What do you think?
Well, great cover tackle there, by the fullback there. Make it all the way to the half line there. Excellent kick. Wasn't under much pressure, so you're in the time under the ball to really get a good whack at it. And it's a line out on the far side of the pitch for Trinidad and Tobago. And again, let's see how Trinidad and Tobago match up against this Bermudan outfit.
I see they have this very tall, I believe it is Dave Rook at number 4. I think he will be trying to intercept or interrupt this Trinidadian line-out.
Against scrappy line by Trinidad and Tobago, won by Bermuda, and it's not Bermuda on the ascendancy at the moment.
Let's see what their line has. But as expected, our Trinidadian team, they are actually quicker, so they're reaching to these guys and they're reaching very quickly to these guys to stop the momentum of these bigger guys.
And again, great defensive work by the Bermudans. Have you seen? Oh my goodness, big hit. And that's going to be a yellow card as time is stopped. Player lift him off his feet. And that's going to be a yellow card. And time in the bin for the Trinidad and Tobago number 6, Jesse Richards.
Oh, yes. But I will still say it was like a general one flow.
Once you pick the player off the floor, you need to safely put them back down. And in that instance, he did. And he's going to hurt the Trinidad Tobago outfit. One man short with such a burly Bermudan pack against him.
Yes, and he's one of our, he's one of the Trinidad Tobago big guys.
So it seems that the Bermudan number six, the big Tashaun De Silva, who also is a seven specialist for the Bermudan team, seems to be down nursing a bit of an injury. As Bermuda clear their line and they're going for another line out, and they're going to try to push the Trinidad Tobago outfit over the line here yet again. With one man down, Trinidad Tobago, you say that was a big mistake by the experienced Jesse Richards.
Yes, I must say that. But is Jesse still playing the two forms of the game as well?
Pardon?
Is Jesse still playing the two forms of the game as well?
Jesse Richards has been one of the bright and upcoming sevens players as well. Big, strong guy, very quick, very light to his feet, and obviously, as you can see, very aggressive in the tackles. And just this time, the overzealousness of him caused Trinidad Tobago to be down a man less than 10 minutes into this game here. And again, Trinidad Tobago is allowing Bermuda to set off the line out here and set this maul up properly. Technically, Trinidad Tobago is supposed to bring the guy onto the deck from early to stop the maul, but they're allowing these guys to push forward on us. And right now, Bermuda's inside Trinidad Tobago's red zone, attacking the Trinidad Tobago line. Bermuda attacking line, ready and waiting out back here. Numbers mismatch, and the skip pass out wide. Dummy by the number 15. Connor Mugg going, and it's Bermuda running over the line. And Bermuda draw first blood here against Trinidad Tobago. 8 minutes into the game. Man down, took advantage of it. And Bermuda's ahead 5-0.
Now we'll wait the kick to see if they can capitalize on this try to add a further 2 points.
And again, try stemming from the indiscipline of the Trinidad Tobago forward here. Gifting Bermuda the opportunity to score that easy try near to the post. Seems to be an easy conversion here for Trinidad, for the Bermudan team, if the kicker has his way.
Yeah, he's not too far off from the edge, so this should be an easy, this should really be an easy conversion for him.
And now Trinidad Tobago, what tactics do they use?
And he has converted, so now Bermudans are up 7-0.
And Trinidad Tobago now have their work cut out for them here at home, trailing 7-0 early in this match there, with the Bermuda number 8, Aldo Campbell, going over for the try, and the conversion scored by number 15, McGowan.
And now we have Trinidad and Tobago now kicking off back into the Bermuda's territory. I believe you should see some pace and aggression on this kickoff, as he will try to pull one back on the Bermudans. Beautiful kick.
No one chasing this kick by Trinidad Tobago kicker here. Bermuda comfortably in control of this game at the moment.
Bermuda is still in possession at this moment.
And again, Bermuda with their tails up now, and they're attacking very hard here. Trinidad Tobago need to make these big hits now. And again, Bermuda seems to be Trinidad Tobago. Nice charge by Trinidad Tobago, picked up by AC from Trinidad Tobago, AC right. And Trinidad Tobago now inside the Bermuda 22. Let's see what they do right now as they rumble forward, controlling the game at the moment. Trinidad Tobago back. Seem to be in their way of getting things done. Slow movement here by Trinidad Tobago, allowing the defense to set up as the Trinidad centers crashing here. Trinidad Tobago seem to be walking their way around this pitch at the moment. And again, bit of a high tackle by Bermuda team here. As Trinidad Tobago wrestling now into a penalty here. High tackle, as I said before, by the Bermudan team.
Yes.
And Trinidad Tobago with a penalty just on the line. And what do they do now?
Good call, Kelson. Good call. I think they're in a good position to try and gain a 3 points. Or do you think they'll go for 5, Kelson? What do you think?
I think the game is still young. I think young Sebastian Navarro should kick for the points. And really closing the gap. It's a bit more guaranteed. as we can see, the big Tasha on the silver seems to be hurt and maybe changed. Big Hasha on the ground here as a young Navarro attempts to make his first points first in Trinidad Tobago colors. And again, this conversion here, if scored, will give Trinidad Tobago three points into the game.
Yes, and this should relieve some of the pressure.
As a young player, first kick in colours, first kick at the post in the game is always the most nerve-wracking. Simple conversion, just to the right of the post. Push to the left, unsuccessful by Trinidad Tobago. And the score remains 7-0 here at St. Andrews College, with Bermuda up 7-0 over the local outfit. And again, the first kick is always the toughest for the young kicker making his debut here today.
But I guess he got that one out of the way. And a lot of communication among the Trinidad and Tobago players right about now.
Trinidad Tobago still a man down, as we know. Yellow card by Jesse Richards, the Trinidad Tobago team, for a tip tackle on the Bermudan players.
I think he has a full 5 minutes again off the pitch, Skelton.
Yeah, roughly about that. We see a high kick in the middle. Nobody seems to claim it. Finally taken by Wright, and Trinidad Tobago punishing the way forward there, but Wright carrying the ball up. Trinidad Tobago slow ball coming out, allowing Bermudan's opportunity to reconcile their defense, as Trezine McLean crashes forward here for Trinidad Tobago. And again, slow ball by Trinidad Tobago here, as they seem to be pressured here by the Bermudan defense. And it's a captain, Felician Guerra, on the break, flicks it off, and it's Kirby Osang under the post. Trinidad Tobago scores.
Brilliant effort by Trinidad Tobago team. And I believe this should be easily converted to bring them up even. Good try by Kirby Hosang.
Kirby Hosang,
number four,
coming off an injury break, back on the national team after a couple of years' absence. Really made a good supporting line of Captain Felician Gerald Brick, and was just off the shoulder to receive the pop off.
Yes.
Try Trinidad Tobago, 25 minutes into this one, and the score is now 7-5 to Bermuda with a kick to come.
And the guys retreat to their territory to gather their breath, get some water back in, to, I believe, go under attack again. And
Trinidad Tobago level it by Navarro here. Easy kick under post, and Trinidad Tobago with a man down level the game back to 7-7 after 25 minutes here at the St. Anthony's College grounds in West Moorings. We have about, and again, Jesse Richards in the sin bin. Probably 4 more minutes again in the bin before he comes back on. Can Trinidad Tobago really hold on and keep and withhold this pressure until then? Obviously, big tackle here by the Bermudan team, bundling the Trinidad Tobago defender attacker into touch here. And Bermuda's gifted with a line out 10 meters off the Trinidad Tobago 22. And again, uncontested line out here, Trinidad Tobago giving them easy ball at the set piece, as Bermuda now trying to crash through the break here. And again, mismatch on the outside, numbers to burn for Bermuda. What can they do now? And Trinidad Tobago covering the area wide, Tabati. And there seems to be a turnover here. James Phillip with the ball for Trinidad Tobago here.
The speedy James Phillip.
And again, slow ball from Trinidad Tobago seems to be in their detriment at the moment here. And there seems to be a penalty here, as again, infringement again coming from the side by the Bermudan defender. Trinidad Tobago get the opportunity to ease their lines. As we see, the sin bin come back on, Jesse Richards back onto the pitch, bringing the numbers back up, even for Trinidad Tobago. And again, we hope that indiscipline doesn't creep into the Trinidad Tobago game going forward.
hearing the Trinidad and Tobago supporters very verbal on the sidelines, urging their team on.
As a referee, just reassuring, just speaking sorry to the captain of the Bermuda team, basically telling him he don't want any more occurrences of that, as well as talking back to the referee is not something condoned at the sport as well. So we can see young Sebastian just clearing his lines. Ball still in touch. And in the end, seems to be a good kick by the young Navarro just outside the Bermudan 22-meter line. Trinidad Tobago in an attacking position.
We eagerly await to see what they can do from this set piece.
So far in this game, Trinidad Tobago has not been doing excellent in their set pieces. One line out so far, gifting the Bermudan their ball. And Trinidad Tobago now trying to get their set piece down. And again, excellent work by Trinidad Tobago here. Trinidad Tobago with them all going forward.
Well caught excellently by Kirby in the air. By Kirby who sang in the air.
And it's Trinidad Tobago on the attack. Big miss pass out on Trinidad Tobago on the run now. Out to James Phillip. Oh, knocked on by Trinidad Tobago. Picked up by the Bermudan team. An advantage play into the stripping blue. As Trinidad Tobago tries for the counter rock. Bermuda will try to clear their lines. But no advantage gained here. I've had the knockdown by the Trinidad Tobago winger. Yeah, but and we'd expect a lot more from the experience of James Phillips.
I believe the Trinidad Tobago side should watch their tackles, though. They look a lot higher, and I think their referee allowed a marginal one there.
And again, scrum again for the knock-on infringement by Trinidad Tobago. Big ask of the big guys here to come out and give another shove. Probably the fifth or sixth scrum in the half.
Yes.
It's very taxing on the body.
Have you ever played in the scrum, Kelson?
I actually started off my rugby career at second row.
Wow.
I was actually one of my club's jumpers in the early part of my career before developing a lot more speed. I was encouraged to play in the three-quarter line or the backs of my club.
Well, it's the complete opposite for me. I started in the line and ended up in second row now, jumping.
And Bermuda again secure their line out. And again, running out to their own half of the pitch. Big boot with a winger on it and trying to be going a bit of a pressure. But again, knocked on by the Bermudan player here. No advantage gain and trying to be, oh my goodness, and there seems to be some player being lifted in the area dangerously in that encounter there. But nothing by the referee. They just have the infringement here, the knock on by the Bermudan team, and Trinidad Tobago need to be aware of that tactic there. Deep runner for the Bermudan team, coming out late run, pursuing the kick. Trinidad Tobago seemed a bit lax and had no answer for that type of attack.
That's because this is the first I think we've seen of this guy. His burst of speed is very incredible. He looks light on the feet.
Again, that's the experienced Antonio Leader, also one of the Bermudan sevens players as well. So he plied his trade in both the 15s and the 7s part of the game, as we see Bermuda shoving the Trinidad Tobago pack here. And Bermuda turned the ball over in the scrum and now on the ascendancy with a big Paul Hall smashing to the Trinidad line. Seems to be a knock-on missed here by the referee. As again the nippy Tom Healy comes around and it's a big number 8 Aldo Campbell smashing in to the guys, to the Trinidad Tobago team. But again, it's a penalty here for the Bermudan team. Trinidad Tobago again, discipline seems to be letting them down a bit, and the referee just about 40 meters or 35 meters from the post, Bermuda may look to kick this just to get their noses back in front. But no, they decided by the number 15 Colin McGowan to kick for touch, and they're going to use their line out to try to drive the Trinidad Tobago over the line here. Tabati as well, the Bermudans probably accustomed to a bit lighter weather than they experienced here today. They may be a bit toasted by the Trinidad Tobago heat.
Yes, I believe fatigue may be setting in at this moment. But we'll see how this goes.
And again, let's see if Trinidad Tobago actually contest in this line out here, as Bermuda seem to go uncontested in all the line out so far. Trinidad Tobago gift on the line again, but they knocked it on in the pickup. And Trinidad Tobago get another lifeline here as handling errors seem to creep now into the Bermudan team.
It's good on the referee that he picked up this knock-on at this time here now.
Trinidad Tobago, I would say, just got a gift as again, Bermuda was about to shove Trinidad Tobago at least 15, 20 meters forward. But again, yet another problem setting in this set piece here because Trinidad Tobago are unable to secure their own scrums.
There's this heavy, heavy Bermudan pack. Big guys. Hopefully Trinidad to be able to get the ball out quickly. But this scrum has collapsed. Let's see if they reset.
And I believe the tactic by the Trinidad Tobago team should be to get the ball quickly out of the scrum, as they are not able to sustain all the pressure by the big guys on the Bermudan team. Trinidad Tobago with a scrum just inside their 22-meter line, and you see the young Sebastian Navarro setting up for a kick
to clear and give Trinidad Tobago team some ease.
But the scrum off of Trinidad Tobago shouldn't be attempting to pick the ball off a moving a scrum going backwards, as the number 8 should really pick and attack the line first to create a proper platform to pass the ball out.
Yes, and that is exactly what happens. And this number 8 is very big, this Jesse Richard.
And Jesse Richards clearing this line. Slow ball again by the Trinidad Tobago number 9. But Trinidad Tobago with the overlap. What can they do here? And it's Jim Phillips along the line.
Ooh, high tackle
very
by
high
Bermuda.
High tackle here by leader for Bermuda. And Trinidad Tobago again. The referee playing advantage as Gordon Daglish tries to rummage his way forward. Trinidad Tobago with advantage playing here. And again, Trinidad Tobago now trying to get some forward momentum here as the referee still plays the advantage. Nothing is gained. He's going to play advantage actually for the offside by Bermudan team here. So Trinidad Tobago will get an opportunity to have a breather if the young Navarro could clear his lines and again line out. But again, that will be another pressure or another task for the Trinidad Tobago to secure their own line out.
Yes.
And again, not for the first time today. The Bermuda captain, Dunkley, is having words with the referee. He seems to be giving the referee an earful and not allowing the referee to ref his game. As the Trinidad and Tobago crowd seems to be agitated by the blatant time wasting by the Bermudan captain. As yet another Bermuda player seems to be injured. And again, great touch finder there by the Trinidad Tobago number 10 here. A Trinidad Tobago get opportunity to take a deep breath here and really come back out here to see if they could win their line out here.
Let's see how this line out goes, Kelson.
Trinidad Tobago had a successful line out just out here, really tricking the Bermudan outfit here. Line out just past the 10-meter line and the Bermudan half. Trinidad Tobago again, quick off the top this time. Trinidad Tobago move it quickly.
Ooh.
Oh, and it's a handling there by Trinidad Tobago, picked up by Bermuda. And it's the leader, missed, picked up by McGowan. And McGowan flushes it back out to McGowan. And it's Bermuda now, trying to be bundled out in the touch. But no advantage gained. The referee brings it back for the knock-on by Trinidad Tobago. And again, a couple of minutes to the half. Game still gridlocked here at 7-7, 7-7 here. But tries by the number 13 for Bermuda, Alex Brown, and tried by Kirby Hosang. Both tries converted. And we have a locked game here, right here in West Mooring, Trinidad and Tobago.
Roughly 10 minutes again for the half.
And again, ball, clean ball by Bermuda as we see Tom Healy breaking on the scrum here. Mismatching outside, throws a dummy, pops it out to the winger. And it's a great cover tackle by Trinidad Tobago. Trinidad Tobago with numbers there, but Bermuda holding on. And it's Trinidad Tobago trying to get back and defend. Bermuda now attacking Trinidad Tobago just inside their 22-meter line. And again, knock on by Bermuda here, Trinidad Tobago with the ball. No advantage gained here. What does Trinidad Tobago here do? And again, slow ball again by Trinidad Tobago as they try for the box kick, clear the lines, And no advantage gained here by Trinidad Tobago. It's going to have a line out here to Bermuda, 5 meters off their 22-meter line, as we see Gordon Daglish gingerly trying to get off the floor.
Where was the Trinidad and Tobago flankers in that play, Kelson?
Trinidad and Tobago were sleeping there as Bermuda tricked them. Normally they would go for the shove, but yet again they pushed it quickly out the line out and caught the blindside flanker for Trinidad and Tobago. Yes. Nothing.
That Thomas Healy, he ran a good few meters without being touched.
And again, that's one of the guys to look for, as we said earlier in the commentary, that bit nippy. Trinidad and Tobago compete and win this line out here. Trinidad and Tobago under attack, big heave out. And again, big kick over the winger here. Nice kick by Navarro into space. McGowan here under pressure, trying to collect. And it's Trinidad and Tobago with the hit by... spills the ball. McGowan picked up by James Phillip. Trinidad and Tobago on the advantage here. Trinidad and Tobago going forward. The Bermuda players offside. And it's Trizzy McLean bouncing off one defender. Trinidad and Tobago going forward with the referee advantage being up. Trinidad and Tobago slow ball. Too slow for Trinidad and Tobago. And again, the big Jesse Richards making up for the yellow card early in the match here. The Trinidad and Tobago scrum half seems to be a bit slow on his delivery. And Anderson Joseph getting himself in the game, being held up and ball stolen by Bermuda as the person was tackled. And it's a penalty here. And ball taken quickly by Trinidad and Tobago. And this is going to be a yellow card offense, I deem. Has to be a yellow card offense. Play professional foul.
On the Bermudan captain. For his not so nice play on on the Trinidad and Tobago captain.
But that was a professional foul there by the Bermuda captain there. He couldn't allow him to get easy yards against him, so he had to give up that. And the break is going to meet the Bermudan captain on the bench.
In the sin bin. And beautiful kick to Claire, and we are now way inside the Bermudan territory. Let's see what can come of this.
Trinidad and Tobago with the extra numbers in the pack now. As the Bermudan captain take a bench. And again, smart work here by Trinidad and Tobago inside the 22 with a man advantage. Let's see what happens here now. Trinidad and Tobago easily winning this, and it's Jesse Richards smashing into the Bermudan outfit. Trinidad and Tobago with a mismatch outside. Trinidad and Tobago seems to be slow on the ball getting up, but the Bermuda seems to be in, and it's AC Wright rummaging forward here. Bermudan player doesn't seem to be rolling away. The referee doesn't seem to be seeing that slow ball out for Trinidad and Tobago. As again, the Trinidad and Tobago. And it's Trinidad and Tobago, and it's Leon Panther across. Oh my goodness, knocked on by James Phillip just off the line. And Trinidad and Tobago again squandered the chance, and it's leader with a try-saving tackle 5 meters off the line. And great set piece by Trinidad and Tobago, but doesn't seem to be finished by the Trinidad and Tobago winger, James Phillip.
Execution, execution, execution.
And that was the Trinidad and Tobago's opportunity to go ahead here just before the break. Ball rolling out into touch. Bermuda decided to use the advantage and boot it down the road with a 22 dropout. And again, are these chances going to hurt Trinidad and Tobago in the long run of this tie?
But I must say, a good series of flip from Trinidad and Tobago, showing some grit.
That's the second knock on there by the Trinidad and Tobago winger,
James Phillip.
Give a Bermuda opportunity to clear the lines. As they try, they go high.
Oh, that wasn't a very good kick by Bermuda. Ball received by Gordon Daglish, taken into tackle.
And Trinidad and Tobago again, slow ball by Trinidad and Tobago, but we seem to get the right outfit. It seems to be an obstruction by Trinidad and Tobago there. A penalty to Bermuda, and the players seem to be crossing. Judged by the referee, and again, Trinidad and Tobago. A lot of mistakes here, not being able to capitalize with the one person shortage here by this Bermudan outfit. For those joining us here at the Rand Men's 50-a-side 2018 here at West Moorings, the score is Trinidad and Tobago 7, Bermuda 7.
And commenting today, it's Kelson Figaro and Tabati Benjamin.
Again, Bermuda get an opportunity to run the clock down as they are man short. And they're going to take their time and walk into this lineout, run the clock down. And again, Bermuda seems to be excellent at their lineouts, except for one stolen by Trinidad Tobago. The one time they decided to compete, will Trinidad Tobago compete again? And again, bad timing by Trinidad Tobago. And again, Bermuda had the opportunity to try to put one in before the half. And again, it's a big hit on Pornhole by the Trinidad Tobago number 8.
Jesse
and again,
Richards.
And again, Bermuda's asking of the Trinidad Tobago defense here. As again, leader finds himself on the other side of the pitch for Bermuda, trying to really test the Trinidad Tobago defense here. And again, Hananera's big knock on Trinidad Tobago can seem to, Bermuda can seem to keep their handle on the ball here as the knock on here and a one more scrum, I guess, before the half. Trinidad Tobago right on the center line. Trinidad Tobago have the opportunity to go ahead.
Good run. Good. Penetrating run by Tashon De Silva, but his hands.
As you see, Paul Hall seems to be shaking off a big hit by the Trinidad Tobago number 8 as he seems to require some assistance. And again, for the Bermuda team, Antonio Leader seems to be making a nuisance of himself, making try-saving tackles on the left-hand side and then sprinting down the line on the right-hand side of the pitch and making sure he earns his pick on this Bermudan outfit team. As we have a stoppage in time for injury to the Bermudan, big guy Paul Hall is trying to be able to get opportunity as well to catch their breath.
I've heard it being said that being hit from Jesse Richards feel like being hit from a freight train.
In my playing days, I've been hit by him once or twice, and I didn't really want to get back up. So I know how Paul Hall is feeling at the moment.
So far in my career, I have managed to evade him in most of our meetings.
As we have this breaking in play, we like to refresh the scores. Trinidad Tobago, Bermuda scoring in the 15th minute by number 13, Alex Brown. Try converted by McGowan. And Trinidad Tobago scoring 10 minutes later through Kubi Hosang. Try converted by Sebastian Navarro. The score remains 7-7 here just before the half in the RAN men's 15-a-side 2018. Clean scrum by Trinidad Tobago here. As again, a big break by Jesse Richards. And he seemed to be on his way here now. Jesse Richards untouched. Clean break from the scrum and big dive on the post for Trinidad Tobago.
I guess he's finally made up for his sin early in the game, Kelson.
Jesse Richards taking that 10 minutes off to really get himself on the board here.
That was a very, very, very great run by Jesse Richards, spamming off two, fending off two of the Bermudan defenders. And scoring directly under the H. For an easy conversion by Sebastian Navarro. Let's see if he converts this. And he has. So now Trinidad is now up 14-7.
Just before the half here. And
so we have about 3 more minutes to play. Roughly 3 more minutes to play before the half. This will be great psychologically for the Trinidadian team, I must say.
And again, Trinidad Tobago seem to have superior fitness here at the moment. As the Bermudan pack seem to be a bit tired, a bit weary of all the scrummaging, as he picked from the scrum on a pose and ran half 50 meters to the try line here. And again, the score is now 14-7 in favor of Trinidad Tobago here. Here, as the ball boy seemed to give assistance to retrieving the ball here. It seemed to be the last couple of play or last play before the half. And again, for those just joining us here, Trinidad Tobago are up 14-7 against Bermuda here in the men rounds 15-a-side 2018. And it seemed to be a bit of confusion by Trinidad Tobago. Ball finally picked up by Trisie McLean, making comfortable yards forward here. Trinidad Tobago seem to have their tails up now. And again, Bermuda doing good job at slowing the ball down, as the ball was hard to pick up here by the Trinidad Tobago outfit. And again, Trinidad Tobago are losing out on the advantage here for quick ball, as Navarro seems to dink it behind for Trinidad Tobago. picked up by McGowan, slipped tackle and punches back into, straight into touch. There, and the pressure seemed to peer off for Trinidad and Tobago here with the clever kick through by young Sebastian Navarro. Leon Pound to the fullback just missed the tackle there, but the pressure from him forced the kick and the mistake by the opposition fullback. Trinidad and Tobago
The attacking aggression has risen in the Trinidad and Tobago team. I believe they're trying to do something again before the half, Kelson.
Well, the Bermudan team seems to be a bit tired, but they still steal this line out here. It doesn't seem to be straight.
Very sloppy by Trinidad and Tobago, I must say.
And Bermuda has the option of a scrum, of a line out again or a scrum. And the captain chooses a scrum. And again, Bermuda dominant at the scrum here. So they're going to go to their bread and butter here. Trinidad and Tobago, again, seem to be losing their grip at times with a bit of discipline and a bit of lack in composure here. But they have the lead going into this half here. Can they hold off until the break? And again, quick ball out by Bermuda team. They're going to try to dink it over the top there for Leader. Leader doesn't seem to guide it on the foot. Jim Phillips trying to make amends. Easily guarded by Phillip. And again now, Trinidad Tobago trying to scramble. And again, dangerous play by the Bermuda outfit, trying to lift the player off their feet here. Taken in by Bermuda outfit. Should be a scrum down to Trinidad Tobago as Bermuda didn't seem to make the ball playable.
The Bermudan player is very lucky that the referee didn't see him with that dirty play, I must say. He's on the other side.
And again, Trinidad Tobago about 15 meters into the Bermudan half of the pitch. And again, another opportunity again for them to attack. As we see De Silva gingerly coming back to the scrum here, as he seems to be down a bit for treatment during a lot of this game. As we see the Bermudan captain, Dunkley, eagerly ready to come back home before the half.
I don't think he will have much playing time if he comes back on though.
Trinidad and Tobago winning the scrum. Trando seemed to be hustled off the ball here, but eventually Garland is Dexter Snags smashing through the centre here for Trinidad and Tobago. And again, slow ball by Trinidad and Tobago here. And again, a dink over the top here. Good kick. And Trinidad and Tobago try to get it here. Again, picked up by Anderson Joseph here. And Trinidad and Tobago just inside the Bermudan 22 here. Quick ball is needed as six and sevens. Trinidad and Tobago fumble the ball on the floor. No advantage gain as offside by the Bermudan players. Trinidad and Tobago with the penalty. What's going to happen here? Trinidad and Tobago should have taken that quickly, but instead they slow it down and allow the Bermudan captain opportunity to get back on the pitch.
I think he may have roughly a minute, if so much, of play before the half.
I think we're back into referee's time at the moment here. Time added on by the referee. As Trinidad and Tobago going to try for the run here, it seems.
And ball taken by try scorer Jesse Richards.
And Jesse Richards barrels his way forward. Trinidad and Tobago knocking on the door. As a big Jamal Clark now trying to make with the overlap. Can't try to make execute. Trying to box has the ball here. Navarro, big miss. And trying to make again scorned another try, a try scoring opportunity here. Knocking it on. And we can hear the disgust of the Trinidad and Tobago coaching staff here. A Trinidad Tobago make yet another mistake in the red zone here. Gifting Bermuda a lifeline. Bermuda get the scrum.
I think for this, at this moment, you can safely say that the scrum boys are the star of the day for the Trinidad and Tobago team so far. Hopefully the men in the line can get it together with it in second half and show us some of the speed that we know they're capable of.
Well, it doesn't seem to be speed happens to be the issue at the moment. It seems to be handling errors here.
Yes.
As they seem to be fumbling everything that they get in their hands at the moment.
And there are some lovely gifts they're getting in their hand.
Bermuda trying to clear the line. Anything goes. And there's a half here. At the break, Trinidad and Tobago going to the half, up 14-7 against Bermuda. Bermuda scoring the try in the 15th minute by number 13 Alex Brown, converted by the fullback McGowan. But Trinidad and Tobago answered back with two tries from Kirby Hussang and Jesse Richards. Both tries converted by Sebastian Navarro. Coming into half here at St. Anthony's College in Westmoreland. Trinidad Tobago 14, Bermuda 7. Anything before we go, Tabati?
No. I'm eagerly awaiting the restart, so let's see what that will have in store for us.
And here we go. Before we go back to the studio here, again, the score is 14 to Trinidad Tobago, 7 to Bermuda as we go into half, as we go back into the studio.
Good evening, Trinidad Tobago. Welcome to another edition of Scoreboard here on ACT, and it's always a pleasure to be in your company every Tuesday evening between the hours of 8 and 9.
We, from those encounters together, and this was a North-South game to open the season.
So the team might be playing well, as we always say with Trinidad and Tobago.
Futsal did that great for me.
Okay, hey everybody. Welcome to another edition of Field of Dreams on ACTN. My name is Steve David. I'm your host.
Welcome everyone to another edition of Football 101.
Half season and things are looking gloomy for Madrid.
Who is a Chelsea fan?
I only know one side of Manchester and it's red. I don't know what any blue side.
Yes, I'm an Arsenal fan. Now.
That's very unfortunate.
I love you, Messi.
Mike, wanna say thanks for.
No!
What are you gonna
do? We bring the feel directly to your home.
Hey, all right, boy.
All right, Bob.
Might a vigilante's run you out of San Francisco?
Like they take the cow and cash and sell them in Independence.
The government drew a new line and we're on the wrong side, so we have to go.
I can't stand up.
You can't stand up, little buddy. You really can't stand up?
You're standing on my hand.
Bed sheet wearing sand crawler.
Excuse me, bed sheet.
Let me at him.
Got me as a friend, you don't really need an enemy.
Thank you.
Jog! What about my coat?
Oh, it's very nice.
Hey, I can use
that one.
Your partner.
I don't know, come right up, catch everybody.
And we're back live here to the second half. Bermuda just kicked off. Trinidad Tobago starts continuing where they left off with Jesse Richards rumbling up to the 22-meter line. Trinidad Tobago de-aggressing in the second half. As we started here, as Trinidad Tobago a lot more energetic off that 10-minute break. And again, ball not being playable there, so have a scrum down to Trinidad Tobago. Trinidad Tobago keeping the momentum going here come the second half. And for those of you who just joined us here, Trinidad Tobago leading Bermuda here at St. Anthony's College in West Moorings in the Men Rands 50-a-side tournament 2018, 14-7. With tries by Kirby Hosang and Jesse Richards. Bermuda tries scored by the number 13, Alex Brown. Seem to be a Trinidad Tobago feeding there of the scrum. Their first mistake of the half, giving Bermuda the ball here. Bermuda up for the scrum. And again, what are your predictions for the second half here, Tabati?
Well, I believe the Bermudan team have been refreshed. I think they will start off as this, just as how they started off in the first half. Giving some of that powerful scrum power. But again, this Trinidadian team, it looks very fit. I think they will be able to counter.
Trying to be a good defense team to be a bit snapping there. And Bermuda finally gets some running room for the first time in the game, but then with McGowan hitting the line hard. And again, bad hands by De Silva there, knocking on the ball. And the injury seems to be impacting them hard, as we see Kirby Hosang smashed in the contact there. And again, trying to be going the red strips to your right of your screen. Bermuda in the blue and purple strips on your left-hand side of the screen here. In the picturesque West Moorings here, in a beautiful backdrop of hills and houses. Trying to be able to get to make amends for their mistakes. Caught napping off the last play by Bermuda. Trying to be able to... And Trent Tobago crumble under the pressure of that scrum. Bermuda seemed to be come out a lot more aggressive in the pack. As they're going to clear their lines and kick into the Trent Tobago red zone. The Bermuda kicker seems to be indicating that he's going to attempt the 3 points. No, changes his mind and is going for the line. Trent Tobago set up very poorly to receive if the kick doesn't make the line, but it does. About 10 meters off, Bermuda have opportunity to rumble across the Trent Tobago line if they execute this set piece right.
And this can be very dangerous to Trent Tobago side. Pretty close to their try area. Let's see if they try to contest in the air or go fully to see if they can counteract the Bermudan maul.
Again, Bermuda secure their line out and rumbling towards the Trent Tobago try line at the moment. Try by the Bermudan outfit here. And Trent Tobago again hemorrhaging the lead here early into the second, 3 minutes into the second half. Seems to be a try by the Bermudan prop here. And Trent Tobago again caught napping a bit there by the big number three for Bermuda.
Dustin Archibald.
Getting across the line. Trent Tobago need to reconcile and wonder about the hash chances in the first half. As the kick is good.
So now the game is all tied up. 14 all. Let's see how the Trinidad Tobago team responds.
High kick by the Trent Tobago number 10, easily guarded by Campbell. Again, Bermuda with a renewed vigor in their step.
And a little bit of mishandling by the Bermudan team.
And Trent Tobago trying to assert some pressure on the Bermudan outfit, who are just inside their 22 line. Healy tries to just wipe a kick. Oh, it's in touch still, misjudged by Jesse Richards. Leon Panther seems to be under a bit of pressure here. He loses a couple of tacklers, still going the young Panther, and Trent Tobago. Oh my goodness, an accidental offside here by the Trent Tobago outfit. Scrum down to the Bermudan team. And again, Trent Tobago seems to be doing two things right and one thing wrong at the moment right now, Tabati.
Yes. Let's see what's the outcome of this scrum.
Trinidad and Tobago here seems to be making a change as Chazim McLean comes off, and then comes Anthony Rajkumar and Adam Fredericks on for Kubi Hosang here. The experienced former captain for Trinidad and Tobago coming at second row to add a bit of experience to the team, as well as the newcomer Anthony Rajkumar for Trinidad and Tobago. And again, and Bermuda again takes it quick. Trinidad and Tobago's off. And again, big run by the number 9, Tom Healy. Catching the Trinidad and Tobago outfit napping. Knocked on in the tackle there, signaled by the referee, and Trinidad and Tobago get another lifeline. And again, it's topsy-turvy here as handling errors creeping in on both teams here, causing not getting a free flow of this game here at Tabati.
Yes, but let's see what experience this Adam Fredericks can bring to the team. He's a very experienced player. I believe he's 39 this year.
I mean, Adam Fredericks really brings the experience, brings the energy to the team, and a really good leader on and off the pitch here. A Trinidad and Tobago again under pressure of the pickup. And it seems to be a penalty here to against Trinidad and Tobago here. Seems to be breaking the bind signal here by the referee. And Bermuda go for the post to try to put 3 points to get themselves ahead again in this match. And again, Tabati, what do you believe is needed by the Trinidad and Tobago outfit to really take a stronger hold of this game?
I think Trinidad and Tobago outfit needs to just compose themselves a little bit more. I think they are rushing some of these plays a little too much. I don't know if they're trying to play quickly to, you know, tire out the Bermudan side, but I think some of those plays they need to just compose yourself and take their time a bit. And I believe it should all come together, because I mean, they've been training very hard. And we have seen what they can do when they really compose themselves, penetrating the Bermudan team and scoring. And we have the kick from the Bermudan kicker, and it's good.
Easy kick by again McGowan, seems to have his kicking boots on today, and pushes the score now up to 17 to 14.
Bermuda on top, 17, Trinidad and Tobago 14, and we're fairly into the second half. And now we have 2 more substitutions by Trinidad and Tobago side. We have Shaquille Dye coming on for Wayne Kelly, and the Fijian born Waka coming on for Dexter Snags, who was also as a center, who's also an experienced player coming off the pitch.
Well, to be honest, Dexter Snags and Wayne Kelly weren't that visible in this game. They were just making up numbers on the pitch. And Shaquille Dyke immediately comes on trying to make the tap back here, but intercepted by the Bermudan captain here smartly. And it's now Dyke bringing on lots of energy here.
Yes, as he's making a good impact as he's come on the pitch, I must say.
Trinidad Tobago with a counter rock here. Still secured by Bermuda, and again, De Silva with the bad handling skills. Ball seems to be moving around the back here. Trinidad Tobago try to pounce. The tackler doesn't seem to be rolling away. It seems to be advantage playing right now to the Bermudan outfit.
But I guess that's what the coach wants when he brings on new players, to come on and to create a difference, disturb the Bermudans. Even if they had begun to become a little bit more relaxed after that try.
Trinidad Tobago doesn't seem to really want to be a little decisive. They don't seem to have the skills intact. And Bermuda again just doing what they know best. Long kick down the pitch again, Emma going just inside the Trinidad Tobago half of the pitch. And Bermuda seem to be doing all the things right at the moment.
And let's see what happens here with this set piece with the introduction of Shaquille Dyke, who's an excellent jumper.
So as you see, the referee urging the Bermudan team to hustle as they have the advantage, and they seem to be taking it here, taking their time as they have the lead. And it's Greensdale for the line out here. Oh, great throw by the Bermudan team here. Trinidad and Tobago again doesn't seem to be inside there, slowing them all down. Bermuda doing a great job of the rolling ball at the moment. Trinidad and Tobago doesn't seem to have an answer for this Bermudan team and their rolling ball at the moment. Oh my goodness, as we see the silver manhandling the Trinidad and Tobago captain Felician Guerra on that play there. Bermuda rummage all the way into the Trinidad and Tobago 22 here. Bermuda, Trinidad and Tobago doesn't seem to want to stop this at the moment. Bermuda takes it to the ground. An overlap outright by the Bermudan team as he set to punch it.
That pass looked forward from this angle, and yes, the referee has spotted it.
Forward pass there, and the first time we got to see Janico Francis for Bermuda team as he seems to be upset with the call by the referee. First time we've seen him today as he loses his scrum cap in frustration.
But I think he's more upset than himself, Gilson.
But yet again, danger as the Bermuda team seems to have their tails up at the moment. Attacking the Trinidad and Tobago team relentlessly. Trinidad and Tobago in the danger zone at the moment. And for those of you joining us right now, it's the Bermuda team who has the advantage. 17 points to 14 against Trinidad and Tobago. Here in the 51st minute of this match. And again, Trinidad and Tobago seems to be struggling with the line out here. Finally picked up by the scrum half, Christopher Hudson, barreling back into all the players. As a penalty here, as overzealous Bermuda defender here putting his hands on the ball. And again, there seems to be a Trinidad and Tobago player down. The scrum half, Christopher Hudson, slowly getting to his feet. As well as the big Bermudan player getting his way back into it here.
He is really huge, Kelson.
And again, the big Bermuda number four. I won't want to run into him any day.
What does he look like? 6'4"? Six?
That could be at least 6'6", 280 pounds at the moment. Giant of a man.
The young Sebastian Navarro has been playing pretty well this evening, Kelson.
He's holding his own at the moment, but he still needs to put a stamp on the game as the premier playmaker for the Trinidad and Tobago team. Trinidad and Tobago had their clutches on the game for most of it, but Bermuda creeped their way back in because of Trinidad and Tobago errors. And at the moment, we see Bermuda defending at all times the line out here. Trinidad and Tobago knock it on, and it's a penalty as it's knocked on to a player in an offside position here. And again, the tactic by Bermuda to put up the light. Tom Healy at number one seems to have worked for the Bermudan team. As the throw off, the Trinidad and Tobago jumpers, Cadence. And again, now Bermuda McGowan's going to kick it deep into the Trinidad and Tobago half for yet another attempt at a rolling maul to really attack the line.
Yes, and again, they'll be taking this line out within Trinidad and Tobago territory at a dangerous position. We saw how dangerous that last maul by the Bermudan team was, resulting in a try.
And we look to see now what Bermuda do to release the speedy Antonio Leader, the number 11 on the wing on the outside there for the Bermudan team. He seems to be everywhere at the moment. Trinidad and Tobago stolen the line by...
Good by steal by Shaquille Knight.
As a big boot by Sebastian Navarro, but straight into the fullback McGowan as he sends it all the way back for Trinidad and Tobago. Ball taken up by Jesse Richards. Doesn't know what to do.
But he runs forward, evades one, two, three players.
Breaks the tackle of multitude of players as the ball comes slowly to Navarro here as he again leashes one off the boot. But only as far as to the Bermudan try scorer Alex Brown. And he pushes a long pass back to Tom Healy, who again dinks it across the pitch, but only to the Trinidad and Tobago prop as they urge him forward. Pushes the pass out to Trinidad and Tobago winger, who knocks it on in the contact. And Trinidad and Tobago seem to be really poor at the handling skills at the moment. The wingers seem to be really, really poor.
I wonder what went on with Ernest right there. He's on the floor now.
Frustration on the captain for Trinidad and Tobago as he's very, very upset. But that pass never supposed to be made by the big prop there.
Yes,
he was supposed to take that ball in and allow Trinidad to set the proper platform. Instead, he gave the responsibility off to the winger, who eventually wasn't expected, I'm assuming, and really, really blundered that opportunity.
With his size, he should have built up a bit more momentum and crashed it within, into those guys, Kelson. That would have been more profitable than what the alternative was that he tried.
Trent Tobago may need new tactics as the backs doesn't seem to be giving the work for them at the moment. Yet another scrum in the game here, maybe a dozen or so far in the game.
And here we have the try score for Trinidad and Tobago receiving some treatment from the physio.
Bermuda seem to be holding on at the moment here, making mistakes, but Trinidad and Tobago seem to be making a lot more mistakes than they are. And Bermuda find herself on top, courtesy the penalty kick from McGowan, and lead all scores at the moment, 17 points to 14. And again, a shot by Bermuda as the scrum seems to have wheeled. Scrappy ball out to the Bermuda number 10, but Trinidad and Tobago punks on the ball, and it's the experienced Adam Fredericks with his hand on the ball. He's winning the penalty for Trinidad and Tobago. And again, that's the reason, great change by the Trinidad and Tobago coach here, by really putting Adam Fredericks on to really make those kind of change, those kind of results for the Trinidad and Tobago team. As we see Navarro making a difficult kick to the touchline, may have been closer to our side to the cameras here, but he eventually made the touch finder. Trinidad and Tobago get a break, a breather to recollect themselves and really set up something proper. And we have yet to see the Fijian-born Waka get a handle on the ball so far in the second half.
Let's see if the Shaquille Dyke can pull off something incredible for us again by actually securing this ball from the line out and creating a platform to see what the line will do. Again, we say that the composure is needed for Trinidad and Tobago to advance, to make some good plays.
Excellent line by Trinidad and Tobago. Doesn't seem to be straight here. Mistake by the Trinidad and Tobago captain, Gifton. Bermuda, most likely they're going to take another scrum and rumble on here. Just about 20 minutes gone so far in the second half. Bermuda leading the Rand men's 15 side here in Trinidad and Tobago, 17 points to 14. Good to see tries from Brown and Archibald, and the expert kicking of McGowan, who seemed to be 100% so far today with the boot. Scrum to Bermuda just inside, 10 meters into the half of the pitch here.
I'm here to see Trinidad and Tobago create a dominant scrum, Kelson.
It'll be very difficult to have for Trinidad and Tobago to dominate the scrums, as Bermuda with an excellent scrummaging technique as well as a superior weight advantage will see them holding off, even with tired bodies, holding off our exuberant Trinidad and Tobago pack.
Yes, I believe they can just get in there and rest and lean.
And again, Trinidad and Tobago behind at home against Bermuda. The Bermudan outfit seems to be doing a lot more stuff right than the Trinidad and Tobago team. Trinidad and Tobago with a lot of new faces onto the team, as Davey turns Waka, Davey turns Navarro on the team, as well as in the pack with a lot of new guys as well. Trinidad and Tobago really need to get the experienced guys to get them forward, as you see Bermuda again dominating this pack here. And again, advantage playing. The experienced Tom Healy breaks from the scrum here. Great tackle by the flanker, and it's a big Campbell running off the pack here. Advantage playing to Bermuda here as Trinidad and Tobago flanker broke from the scrum too early, releasing his mind and giving the Bermuda team yet another penalty, a chance to kick for touch, get a breather here at the St. Anthony's College grounds in West Morris. And again, Tabati, is exciting to see the large turnout here at the grounds, one of the biggest yet. Right in front of the camera view, we can see possibly hundreds of fans in front, as well as fans in the stands behind us. Really firm, this grounds really here to support Trinidad and Tobago here on their first game of their 15 side campaign.
Yes, we're seeing a lot of our rugby enthusiasts here. We're seeing known members of several of the Trinidad and Tobago club teams. See members of the Rainbow team from Marbella. See, members from the Caribs team, the Royalians team, the Harvards team, and now we have Jesse Richards making a next scintillating break.
And again, Trinidad and Tobago just picking on the mistake of Bermuda here. Quick ball is needed here by Trinidad and Tobago, but again, taken by the big Jamal Clark, who rumbles his way forward. Trinidad and Tobago support a bit late. Ball whips back out to Varro, who dinks it over the top. And again, puts Francis into, as Francis kicks it into touch. Picked up by young Leon Panther here, and that end attack runs into the big unit here by Bermuda, and it's Gordon Dalglish cleaning up for Trinidad Tobago. Trinidad Tobago slow it down, get itself composed, and again it's back out here to Navarro, who again crashes into the strong Bermuda defense. Bermuda holding their own here. Trinidad Tobago slow to get the ball out, and again it's a penalty here for the high tackle on the Bermudan team. Trinidad and Tobago take it quickly. Felician Guerra opts not to give it to the ruling Anderson Joseph. Trinidad and Tobago ready to roll out here now. And again, Bermuda ready for the task.
That big tackle by number four Bermuda, but he's slow in getting away.
He doesn't seem to be rolling away from the contact, as Navarro going into the contact, wrestled to the ground by De Silva. And again, tackle not rolling away. Trinidad and Tobago may need to take this quickly. But the experience Adam Frederick slows the game down. They're going to be looking for the 3 points to level this game off. And yes, that's the decision made here. Trinidad and Tobago just on the 20-meter mark.
Yes, and I
looking
see.
Looking to put this one level right now by the young Navarro.
And I see Adam Frederick is reminding the players that time is involved to take the points, at least level it. That is experience speaking there. I hope he does remember, though, that he's not captain in this instance, and and limits his conversation with the referee, as that could result in a penalty as well.
Well, again, smart thinking there by Adam Frederick there to really signal not to take the chance, a simpler option, directly in front of the post. Supposed to be easy for a kicker of his caliber, young Navarro. As we see, the crowd seem to be excited for Navarro to level this score for Trinidad and Tobago. And he does. Trinidad and Tobago back on level terms here. At the 23rd minute of the second half here.
17-17.
Navarro puts Trinidad and Tobago back in the game here.
And the background, you can hear the soca music. Native to Trinidad and Tobago. I believe they're trying to rally their boys. Rally their boys.
So the score in the 63rd minute is Trinidad and Tobago 17, Bermuda 17. Compliments of the kicking boot of Sebastian Navarro.
Now we have the Bermudan kickoff. Let's see what comes of this. Hopefully someone can catch this ball in this instant and create a platform.
And again, in a game of mistakes, they seem to be the one who makes the fewest mistakes will win this. As Bermuda seems to be trying to accelerate a change. Is it Bermuda? No, it's Trinidad and Tobago. As we see James Phillips coming off, and in comes Jamal Stewart.
Jamal Stewart is an excellent player, Kelson. Speed, great speed, ability to kick with both feet.
Jamal Stewart, excellent player, plays both wing and fullback. Comes originally from the Exile Rugby Club, as Jesse Richards bashes his way yet again through the Bermudan team here. Quick ball is needed by Trinidad and Tobago, and they get it, as you see big defense coming in by Bermuda here now. As we see, Trinidad and Tobago doesn't seem to know what to do, and it's a wayward kick, I would say, by Trinidad and Tobago, kicking it straight into the hands of Francis, who seems to have lots of times on his hands. But it seems to be a high tackle there by the Trinidad and Tobago. No, it's a knock-on signal by the referee here, knock on the tackle, and it'll be a scrum down to Bermuda deep into their half.
Good cover by Leon Panto, I must say. Panto comes from a rugby family. His father, Willard Panto, another great player. Sister also plays on the national female team, national captain.
Yes, national captain.
And their younger brother, Jerome Panta, very excellent, skillful player, who I believe is very skillful in football as well.
Yes, he does. He does both, actually. Hmm. Plays for a professional football club and plays rugby for the national under-19 team.
Yes.
and Bermuda trying to be gifting a lifeline here as a wayward kick, I would, in my part, by Navarro, not in any sort of space, straight in the deadly hands of Janico Francis. And he almost had an opportunity to really punish Trinidad Tobago for that lax kick.
Well, I guess he got a little bit overexcited there.
As you see, Bermuda look to bring on Jahan Cedeno at the moment, as he's by the official's tent, seems to be looking to replace Detashon De Silva, who seems to be predominantly on the floor most part of this game. Adamant's still getting attention, and it seems that he may be coming off the pitch.
I think he likes how the grass feels, because now just talking about when the game now started.
Well, he has a very never give up mentality. This burly stature guy here, looks about 6'4", easily 260, 270, you'd say?
Yeah.
Definitely. I won't be on the pitch again trying to run into this guy here. As you see, he seems to be grimacing in pain here. Doesn't want to come off the pitch, but seems that the physio is letting him know that your game is over. But instead, it seems to be the first substitution to be PJ Bragman, the big number one for Bermuda here. And yet again, we see the size of this guy here.
Very bully guy.
Very big guy. Seems to come on to anchor this already big Bermudan team. As we see, time seems to be running on here. And again, gonna add a lot more pressure for the Trinidad Tobago pack with such a big guy coming on there, very fresh. Trinidad Tobago seem to hold off here. And Bermuda on their tendency here. They overlap out wide. Again, handling errors again by both teams, this time by Bermuda. They seem to scramble and get the ball up. Trinidad Tobago holds it up. But Bermuda bash it forward, and again they're on attack. Just on their 10-meter line. And again, Bermuda seem to have a bit of composure here as a big Paul Hall rummages in here. And again, Bermuda, quick ball on the short side. Numbers out wide. The big guy seems to flick it off here, but met by the Trinidad Tobago defense. But Bermuda, great work going forward just inside the Trinidad Tobago half. As the try scorer Dustin Archibald smashing into the Trinidad Tobago defense. Bermuda really, really good attacking. Dummy by the number 7. Flicks it, seems to be a forward pass, but the referee says it's okay. Bermuda now inside the Trinidad Tobago 22. It seems to be a penalty being played, I'm assuming. Trinidad Tobago trying to turn this ball over, and they do. Great ball, and it's picked up again by the number 8, Jesse Richards. Lift off his feet. Illegally, I would say. And again, the penalty given, as we see bodies on the floor. Trinidad Tobago take it quickly, try to run it off, and Navarro shoots it off to the fresh Jamal Stewart, who turns his player inside out before being smashed by the big number 10. And again, Bermuda not being 10, the referee slows it down. Trinidad Tobago really trying to get the way back out, as we see a Bermuda player down. Trinidad Tobago takes it quickly. Trinidad Tobago with Kurt Kwashi out wide. Sakil Dight knocks it on the pickup, and again Trinidad Tobago three-quarter line woes continue. Bermuda with a man down, and Trinidad Tobago doesn't seem to attack the extra person that they have.
Yeah, they should have capitalized on this.
Really and truly, I think it would be a bad mistake by Trinidad Tobago to really take it quickly. Distance should be taken, territory should be gained, and walk their way into the Bermudan half of the pitch. But instead, they try to take it quickly, and again, they fumble it just 10 meters into their half. And again, time off again here, as yet another Bermudan player seems to be getting some attention. And it's the Bermudan fly half. Seems to be getting up and really trying to struggle to get back his stride, giving both teams a chance to get a quick drink of water before we continue. But at the moment, Trinidad Tobago seem to be defeating themselves, and Bermuda are quite happy with Trinidad Tobago doing just that.
And the score right now is still tied up at this moment. With how much minutes will you say into this game still, Kelson?
I would say we probably have about 12 or 13 minutes again left. At Bermuda again with a nice clean scrum. Trinidad and Tobago seems to be driving it through. And again, seems to be knocked on the pickup by the Bermudan scrum half here. And it seems to be a bit of argy-bargy here by the both teams. As they seem to be Bermuda seems to be upset with that loss in possession. Trinidad and Tobago, and it's again, Bermudan captain is back at the referee's face, again trying to plead his case. And it's not the first time the referee is talking to the Bermudan captain in this match. And if you joined us here in the men rounds 2018, here in Trinidad and Tobago, the score is 17 to Bermuda, 17 to Trinidad and Tobago here, with just over 10 minutes left in this match here. Trinidad and Tobago put into the scrum. Nice clean ball by Trinidad and Tobago, but attacked. And again, they try to flick it, but Trinidad and Tobago regather. Trinidad and Tobago with the possession at the moment here. Slow ball here by Trinidad and Tobago. Bermuda again with great defense here. Trinidad and Tobago player, they're going by himself, but Trinidad and Tobago still secure the ball. And it's tough work here for Trinidad and Tobago. Tough work here, grinding the yards out as the ball comes out to Young Navarro. I mean, now for the first time, see Waka, who gets smashed by two players in the contact. Trinidad and Tobago support slow to come here. Trinidad and Tobago slow down a bit. And again, it's a big Jesse Richards smashing his way back into the Bermudan defense. Trinidad and Tobago seem to be really knocking at the door. Big missed out pass to Adam Fredericks, who sends a big boot down the pitch, sliced off the foot, and it goes straight out. A mistake again by Trinidad and Tobago, gifting Bermuda the kick about 10 meters off the Trinidad and Tobago red zone here. And Bermuda bread and butter with this line out here.
Yes, let's see if Shaquille Dight could turn this around in the lineup with Trinidad and Tobago.
As we see some more changes here for Trinidad and Tobago, as we see the Trinidad and Tobago captain is substituted, and in comes Travis Carmichael, number 22, as well as Ernest Wright is off, and then comes
Mark Griffiths.
Again, two nice young prospects for Trinidad and Tobago. And again, poor line out by Bermuda, won by Trinidad and Tobago, and Trinidad has opportunity for a quick attack. As they put up a nice kick through on for Leon Panther, who stabs it through the boot, but misses out slightly. Knocked on in the pickup here by Bermuda, and Trinidad and Tobago get a scrum just on the Bermudan 10. Nice smart work by Navarro.
That was a beautiful kick. That was a beautiful kick by Sebastian Navarro.
And again, if you just joined us here at St. Andy's College in Westmoreland, Trinidad and Tobago, the score is 17-0. Trinidad and Tobago 17, Bermuda 17. Trinidad and Tobago on the attack as Young Panther comes into attack, gives it to Jamal Stewart. First time we've seen the speedy winger come onto pitch, eludes one, breaks the tackle, sends it off to Waka. Waka steps on the outside. Waka for the line, throws it back inside. Wayward pass picked up by Bermuda. And Bermuda, desperate defended by Bermuda. As they see, they try to clear the line. Tom Healy clears the line. And again, crazy run-up played by Trinidad Tobago. First break line break by Jamal Stewart. Fits his own to Waka. Waka throws a Hail Mary with a pass back inside. Intercepted by Bermuda. And that's one of the most liveliest things in this half of the pitch so far.
I must agree, buddy. I've been asking to see Waka's run. And he does have an elusive run. Elusive plays, center player skating to one side while he runs to the other.
Trinidad and Tobago here with a line out here. Clean ball, sent it off the top. Trinidad and Tobago on the attack. And here's Waka. Waka chooses a dummy. Into Joseph Kwashi. Kwashi sends it back up to Anderson Joseph.
And yes, Trinidad and Tobago. Very, very good play, I must say. And we finally seen the line come alive.
Anderson Joseph getting on the end of some great play by Joseph Kwashi. As you see, Waka seems to be done. try scored by Anderson Joseph, and that's exactly what the doctor ordered for Trinidad Tobago.
And currently the score is now 22-17 to Trinidad and Tobago. And we await the kick from I will say the good boot guy, Sebastian Navarro.
Trinidad Tobago pushes their way in front and get a bit of dominance just in the closing minutes of this game here. Tough ask now of the tired legs of Sebastian Navarro here as he sets up for this kick slightly to the left of the post. This conversion to push Trinidad Tobago 7 points clear. Great strike.
Good kick
for Trinidad Tobago, and Navarro puts over the next 2 points. Trinidad Tobago go ahead.
24-17.
Here with just about 5 or 6 minutes left in this half.
And we hear the resounding soca music playing in the background, rallying the boys. Let's see if they can maintain their composure, Kelson, and bring it home.
Trinidad Tobago, a bit hyped on the home crowd. Fresh legs on. Can Trinidad Tobago hold on for this? But Bermuda's ready to make more changes to secure something here. As we see the try score, Archibald comes off. And in comes Cedeno for Bermuda. Trinidad Tobago catches the ball and rummages into half. Trinidad Tobago trying to run out to their half of the pitch here. Ball comes out to the experienced Adam Fredericks. Breaks through the gap and sends it to Jamal Clark. Gets off one. Sends it off to Waka. And Trinidad Tobago backline is on here. Anderson Joseph, the try score again. Gets it. He loses a couple of tacklers. And it's Anderson Joseph on fire for Trinidad Tobago. Just outside the 22 line. Joseph Koshy takes it on the outside. Gives it to Leon Panther. Panther takes, strips another, sends it to Waka. Waka, 5 meters off the line, steps off to Christopher Hudson, and it seems to be a forward pass signaled.
But I must say, very scintillating series of play by Trinidad Tobago here. I mean, they smell blood. They smell blood.
Trinidad Tobago saw the advance on the short side. Bigger guys against runners. Trinidad Tobago took the advantage, but just the last pass in was the fault here for Trinidad Tobago. Just taking out that elusive try off. As you see, more treatment here for another Bermuda player. It seems to be Francis for Bermuda, who seems to be down. Francis, a lot of pressure on the second half as Trinidad Tobago employs a kicking tactic, and the ball seems to be going directly at him. But we finally see the Trinidad Tobago backs at work, really getting a connection with their handling and really getting something a lot more solid and really knocking on the door of this Bermudan team. And first of us, and for those of you who joined us here in the Menrans 15s tournament 2018, the score is 24-17 in favor of Trinidad Tobago at the moment.
We have tries from Trinidad, from Kirby Hosang, from Jesse Richards, and
Anderson Joseph.
All converted
tries by Sebastian Navarro, as well as a game time penalty a couple minutes ago. As well as for Bermuda, we have tries by outside center Brown, also by the forward Bermudan forward Archibald.
And now they set for the scrum. Just closer than the Bermudan territory. Close to their try line.
And Bermuda here under pressure just inside the line, but their scrums are secure. But Trinidad Tobago simply pushing them back here as the elusive Tom Healy makes a break from the line. He loses a couple of tackles. Finally taken down by his opposite number. Trinidad Tobago trying to defend, and Bermuda pushes a high kick in the air. Jamal Stewart is under it. Gathers it, sends a looping pass to Leon Panther, who makes a break down in line, chips it over the top, tries to regather, and seems to have gone out into touch here. Ball seems to be taken down in the 22 by Bermuda, as they try for a quick 22 dropout. As the referee seems to slow the play down just a Kung Fu with his touch judge here as the team. And let's just await the decision here made by the referee. He says continue to play on and 22 dropout is it? It is. As they send a long pass across, it doesn't leave the 22 meter and that's infringement. As the 22 dropout must cross the line. So we have a scrum down to Trinidad and Tobago just on the 22 meter mark. And again, the infringement here again by Bermuda. And it seems to be a tale of the less mistakes here. It will be the victor.
Yes, indeed. But I find on that last scrum, Kelson, that is was first time for the evening I saw that the Trinidad Tobago team actually push back on won that scrum against, I will say, move that Bermudan scrum back.
Well, just a couple moments left in this game. Tired bodies, boots on either side of the pitch here. And Trinidad Tobago have a slender 7-point lead here. And Trinidad Tobago has comfortable time in the scrum as Jesse Richards seemed to be full of energy yet again for the Trinidad Tobago team. A big handoff by Jamal Clark here. Trinidad Tobago with a penalty. Trinidad Tobago wants to slow it down now. And the whole crowd is screaming to kick for the post to put the game beyond doubt. And Trinidad Tobago go for the 3 points to really put the game away from the Bermudan team here. And again, Navarro only missed one kick so far for the day.
Do you think he'll be under pressure here today at this moment, Kelson?
I don't believe he will, as Trinidad Tobago already up by 7 points. And this is really to seal the deal for Trinidad Tobago right now.
As you said, the icing on the cake.
Again, very handy game here by the debutant Navarro, recently graduated from the National Under-19 team, where he was very, very excellent at the same position. And Trinidad Tobago get a chance to get a breath in as well as be up by another 3 points if successful here. As well as really get some time to run the clock down a bit.
He can take his time. The pitch has grown silent.
A hush around the ground here. As this is the ability to really, as we said before, top this game off for a very, very good game by Navarro.
And there it is, the icing on the cake.
And there it is with Trinidad Tobago. Adding 2 more points to their total.
27-17.
Trinidad Tobago almost just about safe at this moment here with the conversion from Navarro.
27-17 at this time. 10 points ahead.
And we can say Trinidad Tobago are fairly comfortable now, but just a couple of more minutes left in this game here. Trinidad Tobago just need to keep their composure. Deep hard kick into Trinidad Tobago's 22.
But well received by Adam Frederick. Pass on to Jesse Richards. This guy, Jesse Richards, taking a lot of good run today. Some penetrating runs. And now to the next big guy, Jamal Clark. He's also our next big penetrating guy.
Trinidad Tobago set this mall up here. Stop just short. Trinidad Tobago really tried to get some quick ball out of this here. And Bermuda seemed to tie this ball up here. And it's taken in by Trinidad Tobago. So it's going to have a scrum down to Bermuda. Just outside of Trinidad Tobago, 22 meter. And I would have believed that Trinidad Tobago should have kicked that ball down the ground.
Yes, to gain some yards and get a little breather.
And defend their territory. But instead, have a scrum 10 meters outside their 22 meter mark. As we're coming just about on game time at the moment, we seem to be now into the time of the referee, with Bermuda looking for some sort of reprieve before the game's out.
Some kind of consolation.
And again, it's Healy passing to the speedy leader. And leader breaks one tackle, tries to offload it, but it seems to be penalty by Trinidad Tobago breaking their bind in the scrum. And again, Bermuda have a penalty here, and I will assume they would kick for the line out. And really try to get the 5 points on that. That's exactly what they do there by McGowan. McGowan plucks it just 5 meters off the Trinidad Tobago try line here. And Trent and Bermuda looking really for some sort of points to end this match off. find the corner here. Their set piece has been excellent today. And Trinidad Tobago really needs to decide if they're going to compete for this ball or try to stop the drive. And they choose not to compete for the ball, but instead try to keep the drive. And Trinidad Tobago bring the ball down. Penalty advantage given to Bermuda. Bermuda try to keep it up. Do they get a try in? And a try given.
They got a consolation try.
Try given to Bermuda with the kick to come. Bermuda claw their way back into this game. Pushing the score now 27 to 22. Don't seem to get a number on that, on the try scorer there. But Bermuda has put herself in a competing position here with the kick to come.
And Bermuda kicker has been very good for most of this evening.
Trying to be with a slender 5-point lead, but the Bermuda kick to come seems to be easily taken care of. And kick scored by Bermuda. But that's the end of the game there.
Trinidad Tobago winning by
3 points at the moment. Trinidad Tobago narrowly escape the onslaught of Bermuda, finishing this game off 27 to 24 in favor of the Trinidad Tobago outfit here. It was a tough game here, Tabiti, as both teams made tons of mistakes.
Yes, I must say. As you were saying, whole game is the one that makes the lesser of the errors this evening.
Trinidad Tobago hold on, but to a very encouraging Bermudan outfit with the end result of 27 to 24 in favor of the local outfit here at St. Anthony's College Grounds and the men rounds 50 side tournament 2018. Up next for Trinidad Tobago, they face the USA South team right here in Trinidad Tobago on June 16th. Thank you all for viewing here on ACN TV. Tabiti, any closing comments?
Lucas, I must say it was a pleasure coming, giving our input on this game today with you. And we look forward to more endeavors like this.
And as we go back into the studio, the score here at St. Anthony's College in West Moorings, Trinidad and Tobago 27, Bermuda 24. Thank you for viewing here today as we take you back to the studio.